Hi friends, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about the if statement in Codesys and how to use it in our code. I will also show you how to write the code of a traffic light using an if statement and structured text in Codesys. First, let's see how an if statement in Codesys works. The if statement is used for checking a condition, and depending on this condition, the subsequent statements will be executed. We start the if statement in Codesys by simply writing a word if. Then you would follow the condition and statements. A condition is an expression that returns a Boolean value. If the return value is true, then the condition is fulfilled and the corresponding statements after then are executed. But if the condition is not fulfilled and the return value is false, the if statement is ended and the statements after then will not be executed. But what can we do when the return value is false and we want, in this case, another statement to be executed? You would handle this with what's called else. An else statement you attach to the end of an if statement. Now, if the expression returns false, the second statement will be executed. The next point about the if statement is that, let's say we have more than one condition that we need to evaluate, and according to each condition, if it's true or false, some statements will be executed. The first method is that we can use several if statements with else. For example, you want to have a coffee if it's available, but if it's not, then a tea. And if they are out of that too, then just the water. Well, if we write this with three different if statements, look what happens. If coffee is available, we can get that. But now our code continues, and if the tea is available, we will also get a tea. And the same for water. Now we have all of them since they are all available. To avoid that, and when we want other conditions not to be evaluated when one of them is fulfilled, we can use else if. So if our first condition is met, just the first statement will be executed. If the condition 1 returns false, then the following conditions, which are identified with else if, are evaluated. If all conditions return false, then the statements 4 after else are executed. So this is the syntax of an if statement that we can use inside Codesys. Now I'm going to use this in an example. I will use the if statement to write the code of a traffic light. We will have three lights, green, yellow, and red, and side of a street, north, south, east, and west. Green and red for each side will be on for 5 seconds, and yellow for 3 seconds. The steps start with north, south, green, and east, west, red. It will be for 5 seconds. After that, green in north and south will be off and yellow is turned on for 30 seconds. Next step, red light of north and south and green of east, west will be on. And last step, yellow light of east, west will be on for 30 seconds. Then we will have a cycle of these steps and step 1 will be again executed. Let's start programming Codesys. First, we need a timer to manage the time of being on and off of each light. Declare a TON timer, a Boolean variable to enable the timer. Inside the programming environment, use this timer with the enable. Press the time, I'm going to set it to 16 seconds because the cycle of our traffic light takes 16 seconds. I'm going to declare another variable to assign it to the timer output. Now we need to use our first if statement. We need to reset the timer each time 16 seconds is finished and start it again. I say if the time is finished and the output of the timer is turned on, then we want the enable to be off. As we want the enable to be on. So as long as the 16 seconds is not done, enable will remain on. But when the time is finished, that bit will be false. Let's start the simulation and see how the timer works. For now, I changed the time to 5 seconds, not to wait too much. As you can see, the timer resets every 5 seconds. Okay, I've got my timer. Now I need to turn on and off the lights. With the if statement, we will do that to control the lights. If the elapsed time is greater than 0 and less than 5000 milliseconds, then just know south green light and east west red light will be on. I'm going to declare two boolean variables for these lights. These variables will be true inside these if statements, and other lights must all be turned off. Here Codesys says that we can compare a timer value with an integer one. To solve this problem, we can use two integer conversion operator. So this value will be converted to an integer and then we can compare it with 0 and 5000. Now we can control the lights of the first step. What we need is to copy this if statement for other steps and change the values. I don't use else because I want to turn on two lights and then turn on two different lights as a cycle from green, yellow and red, so we don't need else. For the second step, this must be above 5000 and less than 8000 because this step will be just 3 seconds. We want to change the state of the lights. So north, south, green must be off and north, south, yellow on. You can copy and paste. This time I'm going to turn off the east, west, red and north, south, yellow lights and turn on the east, west, green and north, south, red lights. And final statement. This one is going to turn on the yellow light of east-west. I forgot to change the time values. After this if statement, it will loop back up top to the first if statement. Each time an if statement according to the value of elapsed time will return the true value, and the statements inside it will be executed. I've already provided a visualization. You can insert the lamps from the toolbox. For each one, choose the related variable here. Start the simulation. As you see, our traffic light is working correctly according to these steps using the if statement. All right, we are finished with another Codesys tutorial about the if statement. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any further questions, don't hesitate to ask it in the comments. Bye.